Well, good morning, and welcome to the Underwood Baptist Church Morning Devotional Series for Thursday, December the 3rd, 2020. So, Brother Adam, if you had the opportunity and the pleasure to be able to see his video yesterday, his devotion yesterday, very good devotion. Really liked it. He kicked us off in the book of Proverbs, chapter 3, and I'd like us to go back to chapter 3 of Proverbs. By the way, you are reading your Proverbs every day, right? Right? Proverbs is there to give us the wisdom and the instruction to show us the mind of God, to show us how to have a better life. So you should be looking at your Proverbs every day. So in Proverbs, the third chapter, I'm going to pick up in verse 19. The Lord by wisdom hath founded the earth, and by understanding he established the heavens. By his knowledge the depths are broken up, and the clouds drop down the dew. This often makes me think of Isaiah, the 40th chapter. And interestingly enough, Brother Adam was here not too long ago, if you've been following our series. He spoke of the latter part of Isaiah, the 40th chapter. What I'd like to do is pick up in Isaiah 40 in verse 12. Who hath measured the waters in the hollow of his hand, and meted out the heavens with a span, and compared the dust of the earth in a measure, and the weight of the mountains in a scale, and the hills in a balance? Who hath directed the Spirit of the Lord, or been his counselor and taught him? With whom took he counsel, instructed him, and taught him in the paths of judgment, and taught him knowledge, and showed him the way of understanding? Behold, the nations are as a drop of a bucket, and counted as a small dust of the balance. Behold, he taketh up the isles as a very little thing. Speaks of God. This to me, and I believe it accurately depicts God's grandeur, and that there's nothing to be compared to him, that all things created shrink in comparison to him. God is in need of nothing, and yet he created you and I, and all of this creation, including time in and of itself, so that we, by the volition that he gives us, can choose to be with him in a sweet fellowship, to establish a relationship in faith, to accept him as a personal savior, and then to walk with him in fellowship and to love him. He has demonstrated his love to you and I by going to the cross that we deserve. Remember, we're created to bring him glory, but he doesn't force us like a robot to love him. He demonstrated his love on the cross. He created all of these things, and all the nations that have ever been were be like the very small residue or drop in a bucket. When the bucket is tipped out and all the ingredients or all the contents of it were poured out, and there's just barely a little bitty drop left, that's all of the nations in comparison to our Lord. He speaks of a scale, and I have a scale here. I'm going to take some pepper and put it on this scale, and if this will work, maybe you can see the pepper on the scale, maybe you can't. If I move or press down on the scale, you can see the scale indicator move. Well, if the pepper is a representation of all the people that have ever been, including us right now, and all the people in the past, and all the people that ever will be, they're like when they would measure out something in the market and scale it out, they're like the small dust. We're like the small dust. But that's not the case, because he loves you. You're not insignificant to God. He didn't go to the cross just because he had to or he didn't have anything to do. He did that for you. because he loves you and cares for you. And you are so incredibly wonderful to him. And you're incredibly wonderful to everybody else. You have influence over people, and you should be pointing people to him. So I encourage you today that where you can, how you can, maybe it's at the gas station or the grocery store, maybe it's a coworker, maybe it's a customer or a colleague, but say something that will benefit them and benefit you and glorify your Heavenly Father. See, God can take all the oceans and expand and hold them in his hand. But he's also got you in his hand too. And he loves you. And he wants to have a sweet fellowship with you. So think about that today. The God of all creation, who created all things, loves you so much, cares for you beyond measure. And though all creation may be just wiped away, he's prepared a place for you if you know him as your Savior. So glorify your Heavenly Father, read your Proverbs, and have a wonderful and glorious day. Let's pray. Dear blessed Heavenly Father, thank you so much for saving a wretch like me. Forgive me, Lord, for bringing any offense to your throne. Forgive me for the things that I don't even know that I've done. And Lord, just be magnified in our lives today. And help us to get through this day to bring you honor and glory. We think of Sister Star and Sister Jean and Peggy Tanner and Miss LaVon and so many others that are on the prayer list, Lord. So many that are suffering from cancers or different things, Lord. We know that this is nothing for you. We know that you created all things and that you can restore and fix and heal if it is your will. So, Lord, we don't want to be selfish, but we do ask that you do allow your healing and your grace and your mercy to be extended to these that are on our prayer list. These are close to our heart, our family members and friends and colleagues and co-workers that may be suffering in this time, Lord. We know the suffering brings us closer to you, Lord. Help us to recognize you. Be with these that need you the most, and be with us this day, and help us to love you with all of our heart, mind, soul, and strength, and bring you honor and glory. I love you, Lord. Thank you for saving me. In the name that is above all names, Jesus the Christ, amen. Now y'all go and have a wonderful, wonderful day. God bless you, and thanks for joining, and be ready for Brother Daniel tomorrow as he will finish out the work week, and then we'll hear from Tony on Saturday. God bless you, and have a wonderful day. Thank you.